For example, open fracture. Macam mana nak diagnose? It's quite obvious lah. Ada open wound and you do X-ray, ada affected fracture. Okay. What are the principle of management in open fracture? Sama je your 4R, 4R, D and C. Cuma kita tambah apa? Yes, early IV antibiotic, preferably 3 hours from onset of injury. Okay, and early wound debridement and fixation of the fracture. Itu je beza dia. Okay, certain center dia practice wound wash out, dia cuci wound tu sebelum pergi OT. Ada certain center tak practice sebab dia akan introduce a more infection into the wound. Okay, so principle dia tambah start IV antibiotic. Different center prefer different antibiotic ikut hospital you punya preference, and early wound debridement and fixation of the fracture lah. Okay. Okay, so boleh setiap hari waktu houseman, walaupun you taking you penat sangat, saya usually saya dah biasa buat lah. Usually kalau saya pergi kelas, naik grab balik tu, saya akan sit down dalam kereta kan. Okay, first kita belajar ni, belajar ni, belajar ni, belajar ni, belajar ni, belajar ni, without looking at any notes. Okay, lepas tu baru you masuk you punya notes. Yang you tengok you punya notes, satu-satu, okay, this point, I tak sure, I tak sempat salin, nanti kena look up into it again. Okay, preferably within 24 hours of the course lah. So, hari-hari houseman you kena sit down. Walaupun you sedih apa semua, kena marah penat, nak tidur tu kan, ya Allah, muhasabah diri kan. Pagi ni memula kena marah sebab datang lambat, tak sempat habis round. Okay, so tomorrow remember kena datang awal. Okay, lepas tu kena marah lagi sebab letak isteri terbalik. Next time tengok where is the proximal, where is distal, where is the career orientation tu. So you need to reflect every day, baru you akan improve. Kalau tidak, jadi houseman ni penat, balik nangis, esok kena marah lagi. Lepas tu the vicious cycle continue. You need to break the cycle by looking into yourself. Apa yang aku dah belajar hari ni? Apa yang aku dah belajar? Sebenarnya banyak kita dah belajar, kita tak perasan. Kita ingat yang kita kena marah aje. Okay, those emotional things lah, kena marah. Tapi kita tak ingat pun. Kalau you tak reflect, you tak reflect pun kenapa kena marah sebenarnya. Kenapa bila jadi MO, we don't have anything personal with you. Bukan you, I mark you. No, we never mark houseman. The reason we mark houseman is you did something wrong. I need to be more careful with you, so that you don't jeopardize my patient and you don't repeat same mistakes. Itu bukan mak. Itu part of the training lah, betul tak? Logically. Okay, so you need to back up. And you kena faham, in hospital setting, our concern, primary concern is patient punya management. Bukan ajar you. But if you help us, you do what you're supposed to do, patient semua stable, round habis awal, then I will have more time to teach you during the round. Okay? Sebab ada yang kata, bila dia pergi dekat ward, doktor, kenapa speaker tu dalam ward dia tak ajar sangat? Macam dekat course. Then saya tanya, dekat ward tu, round you habis ke berapa? You habis tak tengok patient you morning round? Patient ni semua stable tak? Then kalau semua benda ni tak settle, celah mana saya nak ajar you? Betul? Okay, so do your job, do your part, we'll do our part. If you do your part best, we'll do our part better. Betul? Because we are a team. Okay, and most of the time, MO cakap, bukan tak nak ajar. First, you all tak tanya. Kedua, bila ajar pun, buat-buat muka, tengok-tengok jam. Okay, so they don't feel houseman is listening to them. Even during proper CME. Then saya cakap kat dia orang, it's okay, come and teach at our course. They give you all ears. Yeah, so you all lah. Okay? So, yang ni, okay, yang ni saya tambah. Semalam saya tak cover criteria of extension sebab macam tak best lah start-start cerita pasal extend kan? Okay. So, criteria of extension. Kenapa houseman kena extend biasanya? So, kalau you tengok fail end of posting assessment, Okay, work-based assessment ni ada mini CX atau case-based discussion. Okay, and setiap department dia ada specific assessment. Mungkin dia ada MCQ. So you kena tahu siap-siap lah nak masuk setiap posting tu kena tanya senior houseman. Assessment macam mana, apa requirement untuk off-tag, apa common reason of extension. Maksudnya, any incident causing concern. Okay, contoh, usually semua hospital, if any houseman involved in blood transfusion error is incident of concern, memang kena extend. Ada hospital, kalau you terlibat dalam needle pre-injury, is either incident of concern, means extension as well. So, different department ada different incident of concern. You need to know. Okay, tapi paling common, houseman dia extend diri dia sendiri. Pernah dengar? You ingat deadline yang saya bagi tahu semalam? First month kena hantar logbook, second month kena pass first assessment. Usually, diorang extend diri sendiri dengan break this deadline. Sepatutnya dah hantar logbook, tak submit logbook. Kalau tak submit logbook, macam mana I nak proses you punya end of posting? Okay? And tak datang dekat specialist, tak approve specialist untuk Viva. Ada kawan-kawan saya yang special yang baik hati, remind houseman dia, WhatsApp. You do assessment dengan I kan, you nak buat bila? Blue tick je. Oh, houseman tengok message specialist. Lepas tu, few weeks after that, baru datang, doktor nak assessment, sorry lah, I ada lagi 5 people to assess, you need to queue back. Okay, sebab dia orang dah book dulu, so you are extended lah. Betul tak? You ask for it. Okay, so sebab tu you kena plan. You kena plan. Bila plan, execute awal-awal, study awal-awal, usually, kenapa you kena attempt assessment awal supaya in case of fail, kita tak minus you punya mark. Kita bagi you attempt within the time. Kalau you attempt firstly, seminggu sebelum you sepatutnya transfer out, kalau fail, nak attempt bila? Betul, memang dah kena extend lah. Then specialist you, dia bukan assess you seorang. Dia supervise mungkin 10, 15 houseman yang queue nak assess dengan dia. And that's why you have to approach early, sebab mungkin dia busy. Okay, because CBD, case-based discussion is one-to-one. Separate session, assess you, macam Viva. Mini CX could be anytime, during round pun boleh. You, ni kan, you my, I supervise you kan? Dah sebulan kan? Okay lah, do ni, full ni examination. During rounds tau, all eyes on you. If you don't practice before you start, it shows. Okay, ataupun, kau, dah nak habis kan? No, this is your mini CX, describe this one. This TFU one. That is your assessment. Sebab tu kita panggil work-based assessment. During the work, you are assessed. Okay? And your assessment is every day in how you progress. That's why, abaikan kalau orang cakap, nanti masuk houseman belajarlah. Saya benci sangat nasihat tu. Sorry. I get that 8 years ago. And we had very tough time because of that. And the reason saya buat semua ni and semua speaker datang is we don't want you to feel the same struggle. Okay? And that is the reason ramai yang resign lah. Okay? They didn't know it will be that hard. Okay. Okay. So, okay. What is worse than extension? Houseman ni takut sangat kena extend sebab nanti tak dapat jadi permanent MO lah. Okay. What is worse than extension? You pass the department but you don't have the required and proper knowledge and skill. That is worse. Okay? Because you thought you know. But you don't know what you know and you don't know what you don't know. Bukan you, houseman lain yang tak datang kos. Okay? I have a confession to make. Banyak benda yang saya belajar semalam, saya tak faham pun waktu houseman. Saya duduk belakang dengan rasa berdosa di setiap kos. Ya Allah, aku tak tahu sebenarnya ni. Sebab dulu tak ada orang nak ajar. Waktu SME, belajar jugalah. But it was never this complete. Step by step. So we takes a lot of time to connect the dot. Even SMO, I know there's a lot of things that I don't know. You all, bila houseman, you are the chief. You have a lot of time to read up. And you can schedule your off day so that you can come to courses. You have a lot of online material. You have a lot of online sharing. No reason for you not to excel. Except, memang husband tu don't bother to learn. Okay? Now you know why kita orang macam some people are really frustrated with your husband? Because things are getting much better for you, for us. Yet, tak ramai husband yang tahu benda ni. Okay? Okay, so take, remember that in mind. Number one job as husband, kena buat apa? Number one job as husband? To learn, remember that. Bukan habiskan buat kerja, bukan kiss asses of your boss. Okay? You do everything for that, for you to learn. Kena marah, apa yang saya boleh belajar? Kena extend, apa yang saya boleh belajar? Saya assist operation, apa yang saya boleh belajar? Saya tengok patient ni, apa yang saya boleh belajar? Saya assist, saya accompany patient, hantar 5 jam pergi hospital district, ambil daripada hospital district 5 jam, apa yang saya boleh belajar? Kenapa saya yang kena accompany patient ni? Kenapa tak boleh nurses? Kenapa tak boleh PPK? What is the possible complication that I need to monitor during the transfer? Apa yang saya nak kena prepare? Why we need a doctor, not a nurses or attendant? You need to know all this. Jangan jadi houseman yang you just be there, you consume space, you take people's money for your salary, but you are not up to the par. Okay, and bila jadi MO, ada banyak sangat isu. Okay, and kita ada isu dengan MO nowadays. Okay, not only Haitian nowadays, and specialist nowadays. Because we don't train them well during housemanship. Housemanship ni bukannya nak bagi you knowledge yang betul saja. Kita nak bagi you attitude yang betul. Kalau perangai dia macam tu houseman, insyaAllah perangai dia macam tu lah sampai dia jadi MO dan specialist. Susah nak ubah. Okay, and we have tried to change the system from inside. Susah. Saya dah berputus asa. Saya keluar dan saya ubah you all buluh-buluh yang masih boleh dilentur lah. Senang sikit dengar kata. Okay. Okay, so next point is mechanism, then we go clerking, betul? Clerking, what is important? Mechanism of injury. Because from mechanism of injury, you will know what? Fracture and injury to suspect. Correct? Okay, and dia akan jadi sangat penting bila you jadi MO nanti. You first line dekat KK dengan district, bukan semua KK ada X-ray. Patient akan datang dekat you, doktor, saya pagi tadi terlanggar bucu meja, ya Allah sakitnya, lebam saya rasa patah ni. Saya nak MC, saya nak X-ray sekali. You as MO, kiki saya tak ada X-ray. Ada X-ray tapi dah 6 bulan rosak. So I need to clinically diagnose whether it is a fracture or not. Based on the mechanism of the injury and clinically lah. Decapitation tak, ada deformity tak. Okay? So you need to know your hands, your eyes, your ears. You need to train them during housemanship. Because once you jadi MO, it's between you and your patient. And no MOs, no specialists. You decide. Okay? Dan setiap kali rasa macam nak malas waktu houseman tu, tengok. Kalau nanti aku jadi MO, aku seorang-seorang tengok patient ni first time, can I achieve this diagnosis? Remember that. So step up. Mungkin, sorry, ramai houseman yang dia rasa kerja dia buat what work but not you. You have different standard. You all have different aim. You have different ball game to play. Okay? Saya tak nak you terpengaruh dengan orang lain yang alah, kita houseman, kita clerk case je. Plan MO lah buat. Kita tunggu MO bagi plan. No. You should practice to formulate your own plan. Okay. Then, bila clerk, history, physical examination. Okay, a few of you were asking about primary and secondary trauma survey. So, primary trauma survey, A, B, C, D, E, to exclude the life-threatening injury, atom FC. Secondary survey is, okay, your A, B, C, D, E. E is exposure, means kita expose patient fully and kita screen for other injury. Okay, sebab patient punya chief complaint, mungkin the most painful one. Tapi since you tahu contoh motorbike versus car hit from the front, open fracture of the femur. So kita nampak dekat situ. So ABC, compression of the hemorrhage. Tapi dia naik motor, you tahu high velocity injury. Mungkin dia ada, lepas you out all the life threatening, mungkin dia ada fracture dekat metacarpal bones. Mungkin dia ada a lot of laceration wound. So you will need to detect that during your secondary survey. Okay, so sebab tu you nampak secondary survey dia macam ni. Okay, so head tu kita step by step lagi. Okay, and all the wounds kita akan describe. In practice, usually, okay, I learned this from one of the best MO in ED, Dr. Hilmi. Primary and secondary kita buat serentak sebenarnya. Patient datang, expose, then you buat semua. Tapi ini step by step untuk you faham the system because you are new. Okay? And so that you tahu what to look for. Okay, dan nanti bila you akan tengok lah, different people, dia ada check benda lain dulu. Tapi, we actually do it, kita buat semua, cuma preference dia buat mana dulu, mana dulu. As long as it is complete, it should be okay. Okay, are we good? So, be a helpful houseman bila you jadi houseman ED lah. Okay? Okay, now we go to management of patients. So, kita ada principle of management, betul? Your 4R, D and C. And you ada step-by-step management, that is your venoms. Okay. So, kita pergi balik. Principle of management is resuscitate. Okay, A, B, C, D, E. Reduce mean you... Apa maksud reduce? You realign the fracture kalau dia displace. So, kalau fracture component tu displace, you realign, that is reduce. Okay, and then you retain. Retain means you hold. Kalau fracture yang tak displace, you just hold, you tak perlu reduce. Betul? Kenapa kita kena retain fracture? To prevent displacement. Kenapa kita kena prevent displacement? For satu, you prevent injury to surrounding tissue, soft tissue. So bila bergerak-gerak, patient sakit. And you prevent injury to neurovascular component. Okay, and you need the fracture to be aligned and have contact so that callus can perform, can form. Okay, and lagi apa yang berlaku kalau fracture tu gerak-gerak? Marrow goes into the circulation and patient has high risk for fat embolism syndrome. Very good. Okay, so different type of fracture ada different way to retain it. Okay, kalau supracondyla kita buat back slap kat sini. Okay, kalau dia type 1 or type 2, retain back slap, definitive treatment apa? Type 1 type 2 supracondyla. Okay, type 1 you tak payah reduce, tak displace. Type 2 you reduce and you CMR and you put full length POP. That is your definitive treatment. Conservative. Unless it is type 3, unstable atau open, then the definitive is different lah. Okay. Kalau type 3, you buat K-wire. Okay. Kalau ada open wound, then you need to debride the wound as well. Okay. Clear? Okay. And don't forget your rehabilitation. Pre-op and post-op. Kalau pre-op, apa usually to prevent muscle wasting, DVT prophylaxis, okay? And apa HO role about rehab ni? So you tahu, patient ni kena kena buat some rehab. So you punya role? Refer physio, but you need to know refer for physio apalah. Spirometry, non-weight bearing crutches, okay? Cuff exercise. Okay, along the way, make a habit to know how to instruct patient as well. Okay, sebab you tak boleh refer pasal biar je. You dah refer, next review, you kena tengok lah. Fisioterapi dah datang belum? Patient faham ke tak? Okay, semalam saya dah minta fisioterapi saja untuk exercise kaki tu. Okay, sebab kita dah letak implant tu tak boleh pijak lagi lah. Kena pakai tongkat. Okey, so dah dah belajar ke pakai tongkat? Dah ada ke tongkat? Okey, sebab kalau tak belajar betul-betul nanti jatuh lagi bahaya. Okey. And kena exercise kaki, dia orang dah ajar ke? Tengok sikit buat macam mana. You need to assess. Sebab patient mungkin sekali dia tak faham ataupun dia faham tapi dia macam nak buat apa sebenarnya ni, kan? Then kalau you tak instruct betul-betul, you see patient dah ada 6 weeks, dah contracture, dah keras dah sampai tak guna langsung kaki dia. So kalau non-union apa semua, mungkin ada muscle wasting sebab lagi lama dia tak ada guna dia punya limb tu. Okay, so that is your role. You refer, you reassess, you reinforce benda tu. Kena belajar betul-betul. Kita kata tak boleh pijak, jangan pijak. Kalau pijak nanti sengit, kita dah betulkan dah. Kalau pijak juga nanti dia sengit balik. Jangan cakap patient degil. Most of the time mereka tak faham. Mereka tak faham sebab kita tak explain. Atau kita explain macam okay, bye. Okay? Tak ada empathy. You houseman, you are frontliner. MO mungkin cakap, okay, nanti balik, pakai tongkat eh. Okay, habis. Tapi you are in-house. You tengok patient. Tadi kita, saya nak tegaskan lagi sekali. Saya nak tekankan lagi sekali lah. Jangan jalan ni. Saya tahu you memang tak sabar nak main bola balik kan. Tapi kalau you main bola awal, kaki sangat tak boleh main bola dah lepas tu. Okay, so you need to have that soft skill. You need to retain that human touch. Okay, announcement, ortho insyaAllah tak banyak sangat patient. You can have time with your patients. Okay. So, saya bagi contoh untuk another example is neck of femur fracture. Neck of femur fracture. Do you have to resuscitate? No, sebab mechanism dia osteoporotic bone, trivial injury. Okay, you need still to need to rule out other injury, but usually you don't have to resuscitate because tak ada significant amount of bleeding. Okay, reduce. How do you reduce and retain? Okay, skin traction. Tapi kalau you foresee mungkin waiting time for OT will be longer, one week for example, then you might want to put on skeletal traction. Okay, and rehab, DVT prophylaxis, cuff exercise. Make sure seminggu patient baring, mungkin dia akan ada sacral sore, pressure sore. So, you kena buat turning, put patient on ripple mattress. Definitive treatment will be neck of femur. Depending on whether the grade of Carden classification tu memang house mungkin tahu. And you see a lot. Okay, so Carden 1, Carden 2 is screw, garden 3, garden 4, arthroplasty kan? Okay, that is the definitive treatment. And you need to know complication, common complication from the injury itself and common complication from the procedure that you will do for that fracture. Okay, so step-by-step management is something like this. Okay, yang saya bagi before the course. Okay, so neck of human fracture, dah faham principle of management dia. For R, D and C. This is the venom, so step-by-step management. Okay, so admit what atau discharge. Okay, second is ventilation. Do we need to support patient punya ventilation? In this case, which is stable, tak ada shortness of breath, SpO2 well maintained under room air. So, you go straight away to the oral intake. Can you allow this patient orally? Ini admission yang lelaki daripada ED. Can you allow orally? You nak hantar patient pergi op kan? Tapi, houseman, don't cross your border. You don't book for op. You prepare for op. You prepare the consent, tanya mungkin kena buat operation tapi kita akan explain lebih lanjut lah nak pakai apa tu besi apa semua lepas pakar tengok. Okay, so you preparation for op. So, allow orally as tolerated. Kenapa diabetic and low salt diet? Because if you remember this patient is diabetic and hypertensive. Okay, so IV drip 3 pint untuk apa? Yes, hydration. Okay, untuk fat embolism and untuk make sure patient punya circulation is well ni lah. Okay. Then, lepas ventilation or the intake, M is okay, monitor. What do you want to monitor usually? Vital sign and SpO2. And then, GM monitoring because he's diabetic. Okay. Left lower limb distal circulation chart. Okay. And you need to monitor for complication juga. Watch out for, contoh, kalau you suspect common complication untuk fracture tu is compartment, watch out for compartment syndrome. Kalau you bagus lagi, you tulis. Pain out of proportion. Numbness. Apa-apa-apa. Eh, tengok ni aku tahu memang excellent, memang pernah pergi course ni. Okay. Boleh? That is what you need to monitor. Watch out for fat embolism syndrome. Unexplained tachycardia. Fever. Apa-apa semua. Okay. And then, medication. Previous medication of this patient. Okay. On, this is hypertensive and this is diabetic medication. This is the dyslipidemia. And medication for current admission. Okay. So, kalau fracture, you need to give analgesic. Kalau open fracture, you need to add IV antibiotics. Good. Bila review, assess patient punya pain score and adjust accordingly. Okay. Okay. Then, special order. Investigation tu. You ingat? RST. Investigation to repeat. Sebab ED dah hantar. Okay. Kalau contoh apa? Open boot fracture kan? You resuscitate it after 1 hour, you nak repeat the FVC. Nak tengok ada drop lagi tak? Femur fracture. Those fracture yang you anticipate lot of bleeding. Okay. So repeat, nak repeat apa? Nak repeat bila? S is to send. Okay. Apa yang orang lain tak buat tapi you nak order. Okay. Contoh, dia orang buat primary survey, ada cervical, a chest dengan pelvic X-ray. Tapi you rasa dia orang tak buat femur. So you nak buat femur, then dia kata ada sakit dekat apa ni? Bone, dekat bone dekat the feet. Okay, memang ada bruising apa semua. Then you want to do X-ray of the foot as well. Okay, so you send yang lain. T tu trace. Yes, dia orang dah hantar, dah balik belum result. Every investigation ada dia punya late turnover time. Maksudnya you hantar FBC usually a few minutes kalau terus run lah. Okay. Kalau leave thyroid function test, 3 working days. So you hantar hari ni, you tahu hari ni hari apa, hari Ahad kan? Hari Selasa patutnya dah balik. So you need to trace on Tuesday. Okay. And this is investigation. Lepas tu apa? Procedure. Untuk patient ni kita nak buat procedure apa? Skin traction. And you nak prepare for hemiarthroplasty. Okay. So, you nak prepare for hemiarthroplasty tu adalah investigation you need to send. Betul? According to patient punya ASA classification, dia punya functional status, and according to grade of surgery. Kalau hemiarthroplasty is complex surgery. Betul? So, ada set of investigation you need to send. Okay, next is refer or request. Atau request send. Okay, untuk patient ni most probably you need to refer to NS with all the, once you book OT lah, with all the pre-op assessment investigation punya result. Okay, dah prepare chest X-ray, dah prepare apa-apa yang NS minta biasanya. Okay, or any scan request you nak buat. Okay, contoh kita request scan dekat ortho apa? Spine burst fracture, you nak request for CT scan. Okay. Kalau meniscus punya injury, soft tissue, kita order for MRI. Very good. Okay. Okay, kalau nak discharge ada apa? Next appointment and TCA lah. Okay. Are we good with the venoms? You lebih clear? Principle of management? Okey, ini plan yang you kena ada. You clock, Prinsip of Management, kita nak buat hair metroplasty, biasanya akan tunggu, kena prepare fashion for op, houseman, kena bagi patient pilih. Okey, kita nak buat hair metroplasty, ada berapa jenis implant? Kos-kos dia berapa, you yang kena tunjuk dekat patient. Ha, ini kos dia macam ni, ni apa, kelebihan, kekurangan, apa semua. Okey, saya nak ini, doktor. Okey, call implant punya macam promoter atau salesman lah. You arrange. Make in apa semua. Okey, dah dapat. Dah dapat. Implant tu nak buat apa? Pergi autoclave dulu. Make sure esok dia nak OT, benda tu dah sterile, ready in OT. That is your job. In ortho. Masalah besar, OT call, implant tak sampai lagi. Ataupun patient sebenarnya tak bayar lagi. Tak boleh buat op. Siapa kena marah? Okey. Okay, clear? With your finance? Okay, then... Okay, I have... few more slides je. Okay, lagi satu. Same bone, different fracture, different management. Okay, remember. Kalau radius ulna, Montegia and Galazzi, you... open reduction, internal fixation. But distal radio ulna joint, Collis fracture, fall on outstretched hand, osteoporotic bone. Okay, what is the management? Collis fracture. How to reduce? CMR, how to retain? Okay, betul. Kalau belum reduce, kita put patient on Vola slab macam ni. Okay. Kita panggil. Lepas you dah reduce, position sama tapi you buat full length POP lah. That is your definitive. But, lepas you reduce, you kena tengok whether the reduction is acceptable or not. How do you decide? This come the... ...11-22-11 rule. Okay, radial height 11 mm, radial inclination 22 degree, vola tilt 11 degree. Okay, tak sempat nak cover. Nanti saya masukkan dalam post event revision. Basically, kalau you tengok macam ni, so dalam lateral ni, macam ni kan? Okay, what is vola tilt? Ini vola tilt, ini dorsal tilt. Kita benarkan 11 degree of vola tilt. Kedepan sikit tak apa. Tapi we cannot accept any dorsal angulation. Dia tak boleh ke belakang. So bila you dah reduce CMR, you buat check X-ray post reduction, you tengok whether it follow this 11-22-11 rule. Kalau dah reduce manually, tak capai standard 11-22-11 ni, then you depend lah, mungkin you nak same alik sekali ataupun you need to go in and fix with plate or something, wire ke. Jelas? Are we good? Okay. Okay. Okay, and last but not least is ada, okay lah, last 1 minute. Are you clear about USSE and informing? Presenting, you pakai USSE. Jangan macam saya mention semalam. Bila you inform through the phone atau you refer, you tambah introduce and situation je. Yang background and assessment tu is your USSE. Sebab you call over the phone, you have to introduce yourself, state the agency and kenapa you call punya MO. Okay, so background and A, action and assessment. Okay. Assessment, physical examination, action yang you dah buat apalah. I dah clap, I dah put on back slap. Okay. I dah examine the wound, I have sent the picture to you through WhatsApp. That is your action. Recommend. Okay, so boss nak tengok tak case ni? Atau ada tak apa-apa plan yang boss nak tambah? That is your request or recommend. Kalau you present berdepan, you present ini je. Background and assessment. Automatik dia akan bagi dia punya recommendation. Okay.